Confidence interval for mu, 1 mean. We will consider the continuous 1 variable. In the population, the standard deviation, sigma, is known to be 20. We want to compute a 95% confidence interval. We'll go to the stat menu, basic statistics. Since sigma is known, we'll choose one sample z. If we did not know sigma, we would choose one sample t. Samples and columns is where we can enter the variable continuous 1. That's in C5. We know the population standard deviation that gets entered here. To perform the confidence interval, click on the Options button. Make sure that the confidence level is set to the value that you're looking for. The last item in the output is the confidence interval. Say we didn't know sigma. To compute a confidence interval, we would go back to the stat menu, basic statistics, one sample, t, since sigma, the population standard deviation, is not known. Samples and columns will still select continuous 1. And under the Options button, we can select our confidence level. We'll create a 98% confidence interval this time. Once again, the last item in the output is the confidence interval. What if you do not have the data, but you just have the numerical summary statistics? You can still compute the confidence interval in Minitab by going to Stat, Basic Statistics, one sample t, and instead of entering samples and columns, select Summarize Data. Here you can enter the sample size and the given mean and standard deviation of that sample. Make sure that for the standard deviation, you are entering S, the sample standard deviation, not sigma, the population standard deviation. I'll click the Options button to change the confidence level.